welcome this evening to this council and welcome to the members of the public. I'd like to just get the legal things first before we get to something else. Declarations of interest, please. Councillors, you are asked to consider whether you have a disclosable pecuniary or any relevant interest in connection with any matters to be determined at this meeting, and if so, declare and state the nature of such an interest. May I remind you that you should state the item and number and title of the nature of the interest in question. Any declarations of interest, Councillor?
I have a non-pecuniary interest in motion, limited to motion number 5, which I membership of CMD.
Sounds yours. Councillor Fox.
Non-pecuniary interest as a board director of Magenta. Magenta is mentioned by name in an amendment on the flooding debate. And any other mentions or references to Magenta in any of the previous minutes.
Councillor Fox. Councillor Lindlock.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Two declarations. One, as a former member of CND, I'm proud to be, but we'll rejoin. And the other thing is, I'm in attendance of Magenta Living.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Green.
The Magenta Living issue.
Actually,
CND.
Not CND. Thank you, Councillor. I have been noted of the following apologies. Councillor Matt Daniel, Leah Fraser and Councillor Walter Smith. Are there any further apologies?
Mr. Mayor, Councillor Pat Williams.
Councillor Pat Williams.
Councillor Matt Daniel, Matt Daniel, Stu Johnson, Walter Smith and Phil Patton.
Thank you for that, sir. Thank you, Councillor. No other apologies. Councillors, it's been an absolutely horrendous week, and I would like to just say a few words about the death of PC Phillips. When these things happen, they certainly are a horrendous thing to happen, but it also has shown how much it's touched the community of Wirral. The amount of donations, the amount of phone calls we've fielded, the amount of conversations I've had this week is too numerous to mention. And all saying the same things, that for this to happen within our community is a terrible thing, not only for his family, but for the community as a whole. I would like this moment to ask if any of the leaders or councillors would like to add to my comments, as I'm sure you may know. I feel it right to, at this moment, to allow people to give their condolences at this time. Any other councillor?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would obviously wish to be associated with the comments you just made, and I agree that the last week has been a really horrendous week. It was a really hideous incident, and I think I've been taken aback by really the outpouring of grief and sympathy for PC Phillips and his family and friends and colleagues. So I think we should reiterate that tonight, that we send our sincere condolences. I think what I've been impressed by is the coming together of the community in Wirral. I've always felt that the public and the police have a fantastic relationship in Wirral. The police do a remarkable job for the residents who live here. And for someone like PC Phillips to be killed in the live action, he was just doing his job, is truly, truly horrendous. I was so impressed with you mentioned it, Mr. Mayor, to me, the number of people that came into the town hall to sign the book of condolence. just to express their thoughts and sympathies, I think was truly remarkable. And I think it is times like this when communities, whatever their beliefs or politics or whatever colour of their skin or religion, they do come together because the police are held in high esteem quite rightly. So I would add my support for your comments, Mr. Mayor. I was trying to kind of think of some tangible things that we as a council could do to pay our respects and to mark our tribute for the PC Phillips. And I've certainly spoken to Jeff and had a chance to speak to Phil, but I think the conversation has been had. I would propose, Mr. Mayor, just an appropriate time, that this council could pay its tribute to the memory of PC Phillips by posthumously awarding him the freedom of the borough an appropriate time. Obviously, the grieving process is still very raw for the family, but I think that's a tangible way of making sure that his memory is kept in the forefront of our minds and our hearts, and obviously also any practical support that we as a council can give to the family going forward, I would ask us to agree. So, Ms. Mayor, it's difficult to find words, isn't it, at times like this? Because I think everybody's still in shock. But I think it was really a horrendous incident. And, I'm just so proud of the show of solidarity the people of Wirral have given. To PC Phillips memory. Thank you.
Thank you for those kind words. Councillor Green.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. My remarks will be very short because I know that I've asked two of my colleagues, Councillor Leslie Rennie and Councillor Steve Williams, who are former serving warranted police officers, and that they would like to make some comments. But can I just thank the League of the Council for sharing his ideas and thoughts about appropriate ways of marking our respect for PC Phillips. And I think everything he was suggesting, both in terms of the freedom of the borough and other tangible suggestions that I know Phil has got, that would be appropriate at the right time, which he's saying is absolutely right and would have our full support. And just to pick up on the point that you made, Mr. Mayor, and Phil has talked about in terms of what condolences coming together. When I was completing my remarks, I'm fully that thought there was a queue of people who wanted to make their thoughts and bring their thoughts to the family. It is an absolutely terrible thing. And it's I think it does go to show, as Phil has pointed out, the respect and value that the community have for the work that police officers do day in, day out. And the idea of someone leaving for work and then not knowing that whether people are going to come back and that, youngsters from the dad not come back in. Just I think we're all truly appreciative of the work that our police officers do day in, day out. But I want to leave remarks to Leslie and Steve. I'll be off to get.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And clearly, I'm extremely humbled as a former serving officer to be given this opportunity to contribute. I have written something really which is a way of tribute really to PC today, Phillips, and I just wanted to share it with you, and I won't take up everybody's time on it though. But just at such a sad time, this council clearly sends its heartfelt and deepest condolences to his family, his friends and his colleagues, and we've got to thank them all here of us as a council here for all their commitment to ensuring the safety of all of us and all our residents here in Wirral. Such dedicated commitment has unfortunately resulted in the tragic death of someone who was a fine young family man and a true professional. When I woke last week, like many of us here, and heard devastating news, worse news than many of us have heard for many a year. Like all of you here, my heart sank. And we all ask the question, how can this happen in this day and age? How can it happen in this country? But most of all, how can it happen here in our neighbourhood, in Wirral? But the reality was that it had happened, and a fantastic public servant had lost his life, doing his job, ensuring that all of us could sleep safely in our beds, just serving his community. And Mr. Mayor, then I looked back over time, and since 1970, over 100 serving police officers have lost their lives, all killed in the line of duty. We can all remember a number of them. I well remember when I was serving PC Yvonne Fletcher, who was shot at the Iranian embassy in London. And then in 1985, Constable Keith Blakelock, surrounded by a baying mob on the broad portion of Farm State and dying of his horrific injuries. And more recently, in 2012, two WPCs, Nicola Hughes and Fiona Bone, shot in Manchester. There are many, many more, Mr. Mayor, and now, of course, our very own dear PC Dave Phillips. Because every day, Mr. Mayor, police officers go out from their homes to work, and the thought of never actually returning simply doesn't enter your head. They all look forward to parading on duty with their colleagues, joking in the locker room, enjoying the banter and the gossip of the day, and sometimes the very dark humour which gets them all through a very difficult incident. They are briefed about recent events and what jobs to expect during their tour of duty, and they never fear for what is going to be put before them. They never fear the unknown. Their colleagues and their families, if one of them is hurt, all police officers are hurt. You hurt one police officer, you injure one police officer, you hurt them all. And as a police officer, you appreciate that your life and your colleagues' lives and their safety depends on supporting each other. It may sound rather strange and alien thoughts, Mr. Mayor, for those outside the police family, but to a police officer, it is a way of life. They would lay down their lives for each other, and PC Phillips has done exactly just that. He laid down his life for them, for us, and for all those he served. There is a saying, Mr. Mayor, that behind every great man is a great woman, and behind every police officer is a great supportive wife, husband, friend, colleague, and family. And behind Dave Phillips, of course, there was a great woman, his wife Jen. She deserves our greatest respect because without her support, Dave could never have been the fantastic officer that he was. So our thanks to her, to Jen, to PC Phillips, his wife, his children, his family and colleagues. This council also, Mr. Mayor, is part of that family. We are proud of him, and we are proud of all of our Merseyside police officers. And we make a vow here tonight, Mr. Mayor, that neither PC Phillips nor his family will be forgotten by Wirral Borough Council. Rest in peace, Dave Phillips, PC 654. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Lexi Phillips. Lovely words. Could I make sure that we have the appropriate letters that go to the police and to Jennifer and that? Is there any other councillors like Councillor Stewart?
Mr. Mayor, while I am honoured to be speaking in memory of a fallen officer, Constable 654 David Phillips, I truly wish nobody had to do this. The heartbreak of this event is that Constable Phillips was killed by a member of the public whilst protecting members of the public. He was just doing his job. Rest in peace, Constable 654 David Phillips.
Thank you, sir. Councillor Gilchrist.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Your opening remarks, you summarised all our feelings. When watching the television coverage, I was moved by seeing fellow officers and members of the emergency services paying tributes by the roadside. We have lost an officer who was cut down in the line of duty, whose work was protecting all of us. our sympathies are with all their family and friends, who is protecting good people. And in our society, we live by the rule of law, and we appreciate all of us who seek to maintain it.
Thank you, Councillor Gilchrist. Thank you, councillors, for all your kind words. I am going to move on now, but rest assured, Councillor Phillips will not be forgotten by this council.
Mr. Mayor, it might be appropriate to actually stand for a minute.
I was just about to do that.
Sorry.
Okay. I need a minute's silence. Can we please stand for a minute's silence?
Mr. Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the invitation to lead prayers now. Let us pray. Almighty God, source of all authority and wisdom, hear our prayers as we gather together this evening. We lift before you in prayer PC David Phillips, his wife Jenny, and their two daughters. We entrust David into your loving and eternal care, and we pray for all those surrounding Jenny and the children with love and support and kindness. We pray for her in her grief this evening and the days and the weeks ahead. Amen. Give grace, Heavenly Father, to Elizabeth, our Queen, the symbol of loyalty and unity for all around the country. May your Holy Spirit inspire our leaders with wisdom and skill, energy and passion. We pray for everyone here who is responsible for making decisions, that they may serve those who have elected them in humility and grace, offering their talents with joy and a servant heart. May we all be thankful for the roles that we have been entrusted with, and hold in our hearts those people who will be affected by each and every decision. Give to each leader vision, wisdom, understanding, and integrity, that all may live in peace, truth, and grace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, councillors. Moving on to item three, petitions. Any petitions? Councillor Whitley.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have a petition from all the residents of Hotham Ward calling on the council to provide a local green card.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Brewer.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I've got two petitions. One from 130 residents who want to call on road car passengers being able to provide a local reason. Petition of 968 people requesting emergency travel route, emergency traffic through the tunnels at the moment.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Ross.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Petition over 300 names complaining of recent changes to bus services between West Kirby and Heswell, involving the removal of the last remaining service from parts of Grange and Euston.
Thank you, Councillor. Any other petitions? No? Okay. Moving on to item four, public question time. A question to Councillor Phil Davis has been received from Mr. Penketh. Can Mr. Penketh please move forward and ask his question?
Sure. charging fees based on various performance.
If it needs to be a question.
The question is, will the council guarantee to meet RRG, who have already stated boldly in writing that they will offer absolute evidence that they can do what they say they can do?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I would say to Mr. Penger that I'm not prepared at this stage to agree a meeting, but if he writes to me with the case made and the evidence set out about the savings that his company can make, I will ask officers to consider that. But even notwithstanding if that evidence exists, I would still feel that a proper procurement exercise would have to be entered into, because those are the local government rules with which we have to work. Thank you, Mr. Penger.
Thank you, Mr. Right, moving on to item 5 minutes. Turning to item 5, the minutes of the council meeting held on the 6th and the 13th of July 2015 are contained in pages 1 to 24. I will move approval of these three sets of minutes as a correct record. Do I have a seconder?
Seconded.
Are there any issues or inaccuracies in respect of these minutes? All in favour, please clearly indicate. Any votes against? Any abstentions? Moving on to item 6, leaders and executive members and chairs reports. Item 6 on page 25 to 68 of the agenda. Contains the reports of the Leader of Cabinet, the members and Policy and Performance Committee Chairs. The Council is invited to receive and note these reports. Cabinet portfolio holders will not be present to present their reports, which will be taken as read. All questions must be compliant to the contents of the reports. Questioners, please ensure that your questions are no longer than 2 minutes in duration. The total number of questions on any one report will not normally exceed more than 5. Responses to questions will be reserved for the conclusion of all other questions on a particular report. Cabinet members, please ensure your responses do not exceed 10 minutes. Now, are there any questions which councillors wish to ask in respect of the leader's report? Councillor Lady.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. With regard to the reference to the waters, the council leader lays out there many projects, no problem with that. There's no mention of the International Trade Centre. We know that Taylor pulled out, but the leader of the council gives an update on the International Trade Centre.
Thanks. I'll wait till that. Both questions are asked and then I'll ask the response. Councillor Packery.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Just in reference to Brighton Air Town Centre on page 28, there's no reference there to consultation with the public and about these proposals. So can you please give some detailed reassurance around this, please?
Thank you, Councillor.
Yes. Okay. On from Chris Blakely on the Wirral Waters and International Training Centre. My information is that the discussions are still ongoing with the sponsors of this project, and that whilst no final decision has been made, an announcement is imminent, and I would just ask Councillor Lakey to be patient for a couple of weeks and we should have a clear picture by then. Okay. On the issue of Birkenhead Town Centre from Councillor Cleary, the plans for improving the town centre are still very much to the fore. Neptune, we're working very closely with Neptune Developments. It has always been, and it still remains the case, that we envisage a period where we will go out to consultation with the public. That remains the case. What I can't tell you at the moment, because the details are still to be finalised, about what form that consultation will take, but rest assured, before any final decisions are taken, there will be an ample opportunity for the public, the residents of Birkenhead and indeed the whole world, to to give their views on the plans that Neptune will be offering. But as soon as I've got more details about what form that consultation will take, I will let everybody, let all members know. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Councillor Davis. Can I ask Councillor Sinnerin to note the report? Moving on to the Cabinet Portfolio Report, Buildings Commissioning and Improvements. Are there any questions to Councillor Hammond Lockwood?
By way of a friend
own question. George, in relation to item 5 in your report, the domestic abuse fund, clearly back in July when this was first announced that there was to be a £3.2 million set aside by the government, I wrote to the chief executive and asked the Wirral Council if we be submitting a bid. And I'm sure through no intervention of mine, but the family support manager, as you quite rightly say, has submitted a bid. And clearly I'll be interested to know the outcome of the result of that. But recently I visited Justine Molyneux, who's the chief executive involved in North West down at Forest Standard House in Dock Ferry. And that's an organisation which I'm probably sure that you're aware of, who supports families, in particular the children of families, many of which of these children have witnessed sustained domestic abuse. Would you perhaps find time in your busy schedule to visit Justine to discuss whether or not it would be appropriate, if it would be successful, for them to be brought up? Because clearly, like a lot of organisations, they're finding funding difficult. Thank you.
Councillor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's an evening new housing supply. Would you, under any circumstances, support council officers offering up green belt for development?
Any other questions? Councillor George Davis.
Two very quick questions, and first of all, thank you very much for your questions. Firstly, most definitely, I will call and see Justine, and I look forward to doing that, and also look forward to be able to report back on the phone, and hopefully we're successful, and be able to give some training to that board. In terms of the Council Ladies question, offering the green belt, well, your government's lawlessness is basically saying to us that we've got to have a plan, it's got to be up and running by 2017. But it also gives us a target figure for our properties. And the target figure that we've been given on the world is approaching 700 properties a year. That, if you take it to the 10th degree, in terms of brownfield sites, obviously the most important thing is to be able to fulfil our brownfield sites, to look to the future and hopefully be able to give a 5-year guarantee that we wouldn't have to touch the green belt. But if they had to, Chris, then, you know, obviously we'd be going out to consultations for the rest of the government.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillors, I'm invited to note that report. Okay. Moving on to Cabinet Portfolio for Economy. Are there any questions to Councillor Pappas? No questions, sir, Councillor Pat. Can we note that report? Moving on to Cabinet Portfolio Support Services. Are there any questions to Councillor Adrian Jones?
That report has been considered by the very last line of the report, which refers to the future density of 21st of September, which should be in the past tense.
Thank you for that correction in advance. Is there any questions to Councillor Adrian Jones? Councillor Blake.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This question has been asked before, but I'm going to put it back in again. The council IT equipment that officers use, that councillors use, and other people use, especially around laptops, those people who work remotely, whoever they may be, do not have the facility for the current laptop to access the internet through a captive portal. They can access the internet through trusted sites, but it would appear not through captive portals. I do know that in every laptop there's a Vodafone SIM which allows the reception available for the internet to be gained. But sadly, Vodafone's coverage, regardless of the amount of apps they have available, is exceptionally poor. So this system does not really work. Does the Cabinet Member have any
idea when council officers will be able to develop a system that is secure, that allows a laptop to be used remotely anywhere with access to internet.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you. Item 3 of your report, Information Technology, refers to the new council website. Can you tell us why a new website is needed and how far, how it has succeeded so far?
That's a question, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Adrian, item 1 of your report, shall I see? On the asset management part of the report, you refer to internal refurbishments following the relocation of many staff to newly enlarged and refurbished office space in this building. As certain opposition members published so much criticism of the downtown Abbey staircase and the luxury glass encased lift, would you advise why they didn't oppose those measures?
And the carpet.
Officers that we have have done the first class job, being rescued by CT from the dreadful